Hi everyone, let's start. In this session, I will talk about our lessons in IPv6 deployment in OpenStack environments. Let me introduce myself briefly. I'm working on OpenStack upstream developer as Neutron and Horizon Core reviewers, and I also working on various OpenStack deployments as a cloud architect. Let's move on to the main topic. I think there is nothing to say why IPv6 is important. The mouse is too sensitive. Due to the IPv6 addresses are exhausted and demands on IP addresses are increasing. For example, smart city or IoT movement. All industry and telecom needs to prepare IPv6 era. Recent release of OpenStack supports production ready quality of IPv6 deployment for tenants. And we made POC deployment IPv6 based on Mitaka release. I think there are several consideration points on IPv6 deployment with OpenStack. Needless to say, we need to understand the IPv6 concept and its terminology. I will cover these topics in this session. The first two are IP address allocation and how to provision IPv6 addresses to clients. I think the timing replay is enabled. Third point is routing consideration. I think it is a very interesting point on IPv6. There are not this kind of problem on IPv4 network. In addition, we tested various VNF implementation, including Neutron router, third-party VNF routers, or firewalls. I will cover these in the above topics. The first topic is IPv6 address allocation. It is about how to manage IP address pools. I think at first I like to check requirements. We would like to assign global unique address GUA to tenants. In addition, our global address should be assigned to specific address range operator wants to specify them. On the other hand, we would like to still allow tenants to use their own IP address. Global address is not required unless they are not connected to external. To achieve this, there are two solutions. Regarding the first point, Neutron subnet pool is a good feature to manage this. On the second point, we can still use the legacy way to specify SADA when creating a subnet. What is a subnet pool? Subnet pool is a neutron concept, and it defines SIDA pool and allocates SIDA for a subnet from the pool. It is a subnet is a set of IP addresses. Subnet pool is a set of subnet. For example, what we can do by this, we no longer need to take care of which SIDA is used or not. Subnet pool maintains an assigned SIDA. OpenStack operators can define desired IP range in advance and force users to consume it. It also allows us to assign non-overlapping addresses, address ranges across tenants. Subnet pool operation is like this. Neutrons, at first, we create neutron subnet pool by specifying a pool prefix. This is a IP range or set of subnet. Then we can create subnet from create a subnet pool. As you see, there is no IP address need to be specified. Interestingly, if we have no more addresses, we can add more address. We can add more address by updating subnet pool. One thing to by using subnet pool, we can define SIDA pool and allocate SIDA to a subnet pool from the pool. By this, we can use this subnet pool concept to manage IPv6 address ranges. First, create a subnet pool from global unique address. Red character strings are global unique address. In addition, I specified prefix strings all 64. This is because at now, Slack or DHCP v6 stateless mode, slash 64 prefix is actually the only option to work router advertisement. Market shared this subnet pool so that tenant can consume it. And optionally, mark it as a default subnet pool. It is used for tenant do not need to specify a subnet pool name when creating a subnet. This is a tenant side operation. First, tenant can check which subnet pool is available by running OpenStack subnet pool list. Then create a subnet using this subnet pool. In this example, I specified use default subnet pool and IP version 6. So user tenant can easily to create a subnet unless they need to know the detail. One thing to note is a quota on subnet pool. Subnet pool supports quota. In IPv4 case, quota is counted by the number of assigned IP addresses. On the other hand, in IPv6, quota is calculated as a number of slash 64 subnets. If the subnet pool quota is 3, tenant can allocate 3/64 subnets. I think /64 is the minimum allocation unit, so it is really reasonable. This is how global unique address pool is managed. The next topic is IP address configuration. This is how IPv6 addresses and additional information configured to VM or IPv6 client. This is IPv6 specification. And now there are three configuration modes: SLAC, DHCP stateless, and DHCP stateful. I think it is if you are running IPv6 environment, you might be familiar with that. here is a rough summary of three modes. In SLAC, IPv6 address of a client is configured based on router advertisement from upstream router. Default gateway is also configured based on the router IP address. And recently, optionally, DNS information can be advertised through router advertisement messages. One thing to note is only 64 prefix is supported. In DHCP v6 stateless, IPv6 address is configured based on router advertisement. This is the same as SLAC mode. Different thing is other information is retrieved from DHCP v6. I think this is the one mostly commonly used. It is because it was the only way to distribute DNS information before DNS support in RA was was added. DHCP v6 stateful, this is different from the above two. All information, including addresses, are configured based on DHCP v6 protocol. I heard the gateway is not configured properly. Honestly, I'm not so familiar with DHCP v6 stateful. This information might be wrong. So that these address configuration mode is determined based on router advertisement flags. Two flags, there are two flags, managed flag and other flag. Neutron exposes all modes, but it is necessary to, not necessarily all modes are available. It depends on backend implementation. So how Neutron allows us to specify this behavior? Neutron has two attributes related to IPv6 configurations. Two modes, IPv6 address mode and RA mode. There are constraints between these two attributes. It is summarized in the OpenStack network guide. Oh, let's see it. Oh, this is a bit long table. Oh, I think, I hope. Oh. Yeah. The the top entry is just for backend compatibility. And the 6 entries at the bottom is invalid configuration. The remaining combination, valid combination, and these three modes supported by Neutron reference implementation. It means layer 3 agent and DHCP agent. The other remaining combination not supported by reference implementation, but if we want to different router implementation, what value should I specify? I'd like to understand what it means. Well, let's see it more detail. First one is IPv6 address mode. It specifies how IPv6 address is generated and assigned. The main player is IP address management, IPAM, and DHCP implementation, DNS mask, DHCP agent. In this mode, in Slurk and DHCP stateless mode, address lower half bits of addresses are generated from MAC addresses. Neutron handles IP address generation specially for these two modes. The second mode is IPv6 RA mode. This mode specifies how Neutron router sends router advertisement. If Neutron router is provisioned, if these three modes are specified, Neutron set up router advertised daemon, array DVD, on router network namespace, and this daemon sends router advertisement to client. Router advertisement flag are set accordingly based on subnet attributes. If not attribute is not specified, Neutron does nothing. So let's apply these understandings to deployment scenarios. The left one is typical Neutron deployment. This is the easiest case. Neutron router is created by Neutron L3 plugin. If VNF, for example, virtual appliance, or integrated with Neutron, this pattern is also applied. The middle one is tenant router case, but VNF is not well integrated with Neutron. Tenant requests to create a router, but VM act as a router, but from Neutron perspective, it is just a VM, not a router. So most VMS does not provide L3 plugin integration, so this scenario, I think this scenario is worth considered. The right one is provider router case. In this case, tenant just connects their VM to existing network prepared by operators. Upstream router might be managed by different networking team. So what IPv6 mode should be used? The first case is tenant Neutron router scenario. This is simple. What we need to do is specify one of these values to IP address address mode and array mode. If third-party layer 3 plugins provided, the behavior needs to be checked, but there is less, I think it should work in most cases. The next one is tenant BNF router case. In this case, it is a bit complicated. BNF, in this case, BNF managed by outside of Neutron. Yeah. So first, Slack works well as from Neutron perspective, array mode is not set. Or Neutron router does not exist. It is just a VM. So this means there is nothing to do in Neutron side. BNF router will send router advertisement for VM. So there is no problem. Second one, DHCP V6 stateless case. In this case, router advertisement is sent from BNF routers. It is the same for Slack. Yeah. On the other hand, for DHCP V6, Neutron, in this case, address mode is DHCP V4, V6 stateless. So Neutron tried to serve DHCP V6 for IPv6 addresses. If VNF router also provides DHCP V6, information from two DHCP server might be conflict. So my current suggestion is to disable DHCP V6 in DNS side, VNF side, and use Neutron DHCP V6. Well, DHCP V6 stateful case is similar, the same same discussion on DHCP V6 stateless applied to this scenario. The last case is provider router. In this case, upstream router sends router advertisement. Most discussion apply to the VNF router case apply to this scenario. DHCP Slack works okay. DHCP V6 stateless mode, the same discussion apply to here, and the suggestion is to disable DHCP V6 in VNF side. DHCP V6 stateful is more complicated. In this case, IPv6 address is maintained by Neutron side, but the upstream router does not collaborate with Neutron, so there is no way to know which, no way the upstream router knows what IPv6 address is configured. I think it does not work, and we should avoid this scenario for provider router case. As a last slide of this topic, I'd like to share a small result of IPv6-2 modes per VNF. For Slack, only Cisco VNF supports DNS option in array message. Bit surprising thing is Neutron array DVD implementation doesn't support DNS option, but it's as far as I checked, it seems just we are not passing DNS information to array DVD configuration. For DHCP V6 stateless case, some VNF does not support this mode. Intersect and Palo Alto. These appliances only support Slack. There is no configuration to change it. In addition, DNS option in Neutron is not provided. This needs some investigation. This is just a snapshot result. So, but it shows us throughout test is required. Let's move on to the routing topic. I'd like to cover two routing topics. The first one is how to reach tenants network from the internet. Why it is important? Someone thinks it is a requirement for internet. To deliver packet from the internet to tenant networks, the upstream router must know routes to tenant network. In IPv6, tenant network get global address dynamically. So the root table on the upstream left side needs to be updated. Tenant network and router are created by self-service, so we need some mechanism to update routes automatically. There are several possible options to update the route to tenant network dynamically. The one option is dynamic routing using routing protocol. BGP and OSPF, I think, a good option. The other option is to use prefix delegation. Let's look at them one by one. The first one is dynamic routing with BGP. Neutron itself supports BGP dynamic routing, route advertisement. In this case, OpenStack deployment act as one AS. And BGP peering is created between BGP agent on the top and the upstream router. Then when tenant network and router is created, BGP agent advertise new route to the upstream routers. Note that only networks which belong to the same address scope of the external network are advertised. About address scope, I will explain it in the coming slide. It is a concept which IP addresses can communicate directly with each other. This is BGP. The second option is dynamic routing is OSPF. OSPF can be used for dynamic routing configuration. Router relationship is created between the router and upstream router. Once a relationship is established, route to tenant router advertises route to tenant network. OSPF is useful for smaller deployment as some operators do not want to run BGP in their data center. In addition, most VNF routers support OSPF, and it is a good option, I think. But unfortunately, there is no Neutron integration is implemented so far. The third option is prefix delegation. IPv6 prefix delegation is a completely different approach from the dynamic routing. This is originally IP address management mechanism, and IP address management mechanism. There are two players, prefix delegation, PD server, and PD client. The upstream router is a prefix delegation server, and this manages IP address range, whole IP address ranges for tenant network. OpenStack itself does not need to manage IP addresses ranges. Then Neutron router is prefix deletion client. If it requests, prefix delegation server assigns IP address ranges to a Neutron router, and the Neutron router assigns an IP address to backend VM from that range. The important point is the upstream router can set up a route to Neutron router when assigning IP address range. The router knows IP address or Neutron router prefix delegation client, so it can configure routes to tenant network. So there is a Neutron integration, and it is a good option. Here is a comparison of these three techniques. There are merit and demerit, as I already covered. And so choice depends on network. I think choices depend on the networking policy and what kind of router types you use. For example, BGP has a good Neutron integration, but if operator do not want to use BGP, we cannot use. OSPF is another good option, but the Neutron integration is not there, so there are some orchestration mechanisms required. For prefix delegation, it is good Neutron integration, but one limitation is it only supports simple topology. We cannot nest tenant router. For example, if a tenant want to place a firewall before a tenant router, so backend router cannot be, IP address of the backend router cannot be configured through prefix delegation, I think. This is the first topic of routing considerations. The second routing consideration is how to prevent unauthorized global addresses. Neutron allows tenant to assign arbitrary IP addresses. In addition, in IPv6, global unique addresses are assigned to tenant from specific ranges. So what happens if someone assigns overlapping address ranges with other tenant? We need a way to block such an authorized global unique address assigned by tenant. The answer is Neutron address scope. This concept is Neutron specific, and this is a concept to define which IP addresses can directly communicate each other. Subnet pool is, this example. In this example, NET1 and NET2 associated with address scope 1 through subnet pool 1. NET3 is associated with different address scope. In this case, traffic between net 1 and net 2 can be forward, allowed to forward, but router drops traffic from net 3 to net 1 because they belong to different address scopes. By using address scope, operator can only allow traffic from IP range they authorize to internet. To do this, administrator prepare a shared address scope and shared subnet pool. And tenant user, create a shared address scope and subnet pool, in this case, address scope 1 and 2. And then create a subnet of external network, the left side, from the above subnet pool. So at now, external net belongs to address scope 1. And tenant user create net 2 and create subnet from subnet pool 1. So the net 2 tenant network belongs to address scope 1, 2. So these two networks, network 2, tenant network, and external network, can communicate directly. On the other hand, tenant creates another network, net 3, from another subnet pool or specify CIDR explicitly, they cannot communicate to the outside. So this is a summary of the just command line. No new things appears here. Okay. Finally, I'd like to share some interesting topics we learned. I think the third thing is interesting. Windows support address randomization for EUI 64 addresses. It randomizes the lower half of 64 bits. It randomizes the lower half of 64 bits. This area corresponds to MAC addresses. Also, Windows support or ephemeral IPv6 address is supported. And they are randomization is enabled by default. It works for Slack case because Neutron isn't involved in any address configuration. But generated IP addresses will be different from Neutron port database. So debugging might be difficult. This is a limitation of the current current Neutron and Windows support. Also, most VNF does not provide Neutron layer 3 plugin, so we need, if we want to use such VNF, we need some orchestrator to retrieve information from Neutron. For example, we need IPv6 address, two attributes from of subnet to configure IPv4 array flags. Other example is address scope, and we need to retrieve address scope information associated with the Neutron network. Okay, that's the last slide. I talked about my experience on IPv6 POC deployment. I hope it helps introduction of IPv6 deployment. As a small summary, most things works well, but there are some things remaining to be improved. Yay. Let's share knowledge and upstream it. Thanks. Thanks for coming.